What's up, guys? My name is Javier and welcome back. In this video, we're going to take a look at another set of 12-volt tools. And this time around, we're going to check out what Makita has to offer with their 12-volt drill and impact driver. I got them as a combo kit that includes two lithium-ion batteries, and they take around 60 minutes of charge, and a very premium camera-style hard case. Even the inside screams premium with foam-lined walls, the use of molded foam to neatly store your drill, impact driver, charger, and even a spot for an extra battery. And the top part of the case has a nice fabric pocket to store the manuals. As you guys may already know, my favorite power tool platform is the 12-volt platform. And that's because of the compact size, the low weight, and let's not forget to mention that they have plenty of power for the size. I found out that you don't always need the larger 18-volt power tools to run everyday tasks such as running screws and drilling small holes. Both of these compact 12-volt tools can easily run 3-inch deck screws. These screws are driven into the side of a 2x4 without the aid of pre-drilling any pilot holes. Now, these models are very compact and light, and this is exactly what you're looking for in a 12-volt power tool. These are noticeably lighter than some of the other competing brands' models, coming in at an anorexic 2 pounds for the impact driver and only 2.2 pounds for the drill. If you're going to be holding a drill for a long time, low weight is something you're looking for as to not wear out your arm in the long haul. I recently had to remove some peeling paint from under the eaves of a roof, so I used a paint scraper attachment attached to a drill, and I used several drills ranging from 18 volt to 12 volt. And it became very obvious that not only were the 18 volt drills overkill, because the 12 volt tools can easily do the same thing, but because of the added weight of the 18 volt drills, it really took a toll on my arms and shoulders because all the work was done overhead, so my arms would get tired, and I had to take a ton of breaks. This is easily where the 12-volt tools shine because of the much lower weight. And out of the 12-volt tools that I used, it was apparent to my arms and shoulders that the Makita 12-volt drill was lighter than the others. And because of this, I would get more work done because I would take less breaks and work longer in the same amount of time. As far as features go, they are pretty well equipped with a solid and comfortable grip. It's a bit fatter grip than the other 12-volt brands, but the handle tapers nicely at the top, making it very comfortable and ergonomic in my opinion. The balance is great as neither tool is front or back heavy, and they both use plenty of rubber overmold on the handle for a great grip and throughout the tool itself, such as the back and sides. For one, better impact resistance if you ever drop the tool, and two, so they don't slide around when you set them down. And as an added benefit, it won't scratch a delicate surface. Both come with a bright LED light right above the trigger, with a 10-second afterglow delay, which is very handy for working in dark areas. This is one of those things you don't know how useful it is until you need it and are working in a poorly lit area. The drill has an 18 settings torque limiting clutch, along with a drill mode for full torque and a 2-speed transmission for high torque or high speed. It uses a 3/8 inch plastic chuck to grip tightly onto bits. It's not a ratcheting chuck, but it had no problem holding on tight to a bit with the largest shank that would fit into the chuck, which was a 3/8 inch drill bit. I drilled various holes and not once did the bit slip. This was impressive considering the chuck doesn't ratchet. Now let's take a look at the drill spins a bit to see if it has any wobble. In this demonstration, I'll be using a tiny 1/16 inch drill bit. With a bit this small, any wobble in the chuck will be very noticeable. So as we can see here, the bit spun true with no wobble from the chuck. As for the impact driver, it uses a 2-handed 1/4 inch hex chuck to insert and remove bits. And right behind the chuck is something I've never seen in any power tool before, a glow-in-the-dark sleeve. Now before you guys start thinking it's only a gimmick, it does have a useful purpose, which is to help find the impact driver in a completely dark room, such as if the power ever goes out due to a power outage. A couple of features that I found missing on both of these tools is no built-in bell clip or a slot to add one, and neither has a fuel gauge to show you the remaining battery charge. The drill is rated for a max 200 inch-pounds of torque, and the impact driver's torque rating at a max 800 inch-pounds. Of course, these are just stats on paper, so let's take a quick look at what these 12-volt power tools are really capable of. We'll be right back. So with that, we can see that these are capable little tools for a wide variety of tasks, from driving screws, lag screws, to drilling very small holes. I thought the 200 inch-pounds torque rating for the drill was dead on. It's not the most powerful 12-volt drill on the market, but it's got more than enough power for its intended purpose, driving screws and drilling small holes. And the size and comfort are what really make it stand out. I would even compare it to a small Japanese sports car that's light, quick, and can handle very well. As for the impact driver, I found the 800 inch-pounds torque rating to be a bit conservative, as it performs more like impact drivers that claim to have 900 to 1,000 inch-pounds of torque. So far, I enjoy using both, and I thought they were great choices for someone looking into starting into a 12-volt line. And the price is also great for the combo set, as I've seen several retailers offer the combo set for around $120, making it a great combo deal. Alright guys, thanks for stopping by and checking out the Makita 12-volt drill and impact driver. Let me know what you guys think of these 12-volt power tools, and don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my YouTube channel, follow me on Facebook and Google+, and I'll see you guys in the next video.